problem is to write a program in Python to check if a number is positive, negative, or zero. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program in Python that would allow us to check if a number is positive, negative, or zero. So this can be achieved with a simple logic that all we need to do is we need to use a simple logic over there. So to figure it out, all we need to do is understand how a number can be positive over here. To understand how a number can be positive, let's have a look on a small logic that we are going to put over here. So I'm writing down some positive numbers over here like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and up to like it's 100, okay? Similarly, I am writing minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6 and it can also go up to like 100, right? Now, what is the difference between these numbers over here? That one is in positive, the other one is negative. But if we will see the logic over here, all these numbers are greater than 0 and all these numbers are smaller than 0, right? So what we need to do, we need to use this simple logic that all the numbers that are greater than 0 are the positive number, all the numbers that are smaller than 0 are the negative number, and a number that is equal to 0 is a 0 number. So let's use this simple logic in our Python. So here, first of all, what all things we will be needing? We will be needing variables over here. That means we need to take an input from the user that for which number the person want to check if it is positive, negative, or a zero number. Then secondly, we need to put conditions over here to check if a number is positive, negative, or a zero number, along with using the operators over here. Lastly, we have to print that what would happen in a particular condition. So let's first of all take an input from the user. So I'm taking a variable called as number. Number is equals to, I'll take the input in the integers, input. Enter a number here. So you can create a variable over here where you can take the input from the user, or you can do one thing that you can create a predefined variable over here. Both the choices are up to you. Now next thing that we are going to do is we will be using here conditional statements along with operators. So what condition we need to give over here? First of all, first condition should be that all the numbers which are greater than zero are positive number. So how we will be writing that? We will be writing in this way that if our number, whatever our number is, if it is greater than 0, that let's say our number is 5. And if 5 is greater than 0, in that condition we will print that the number is positive. Similarly, I'll be writing elif. Elif is used when we want to give multiple conditions, otherwise we directly use else. So here we want to give one more condition, that's why I'm using elif over here. Elif is a combination of else if. So elif. We'll be giving our second condition that if our number is equal to 0, in that condition, because 0 is neither positive nor negative, it is a neutral number. So we can write the number is 0. Else, so if a number is neither positive nor 0, then definitely it is negative. So we will directly print the number is negative. So now let's run the program and let's see what happens. So if I run this program and write over here any number, let's say I'm writing 45, it would give me it is a positive number, which we already know. Again, if I run it and now at this time I write minus 45, it would tell me that it is a negative number. Again, if I run it and this time if I write 0, it would tell me that the number is 0. That means our program is working perfectly fine, and in I guess just 10 lines we have written a program. If I remove this unwanted line, then maybe in just 8 lines we have written this program where we have taken an input from the user that which number they want to check for. Then after that, we need to apply conditional statements along with the operators that it is a greater than equal to. So two operations have been used over here. So all we need to do over here is first of all, take the input from the user as a variable. Then we need to apply conditional statements along with the operators. Here we have used two operators. One is the greater than operator. Another one is the equal to operator. We have used conditional statements if, elif, else, and then printed the output. So I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions, and for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.